SLOSS funds and Georgia Department of Transportation Local Maintenance and Improvement Program funds, also known as LMIG. LMIG is a program that allocates transportation money to local governments and many communities actually use it for resurfacing projects. The GI strategy, the formula that bases it off of population and the street knowledge to determine the funding amount for a community. For the city of Austin, we are eligible and will have already received $439,566 in LMIG funds. As part of this, there is a 30% match requirement, which is another $131,869. So this means that we'll have to have a total project cost for resurfacing for the LMIG 2015 in the amount of $571,436. As you are aware, the last council meeting, we actually did go ahead and approve to start resurfacing two streets, which was $2,000. That project was in the amount of $204,665. On December 5th, we received three contractors to bid to resurface 13 additional streets, which is included in your packet for the map. The low bid, excuse me, was from the Scruggs Company in the amount of $341,704.29. Our engineer's estimate was $447,550. So with that, Emily, being under budget, we would ask that you consider approving the low bid for Scruggs Company in the amount of $341,704.29, plus the 10% contingency. If you have any questions, I'll have to answer.
Anybody have any questions?
Yeah, did this the same reason that we used to bid names for?
Right.
How's this being done now?
Well, we actually still have an old list because in the last few years with less money, we had less to spend. So therefore, we've got a list that's been submitted in the past years. And we accept streets at any time. And we've mentioned this before. Anytime you have a street submitted, so they put it on the list and evaluate the condition of it. And compare it to that, I think we talked about that last month. You mentioned Cypress Street, and I went back and told that, added it to the list and evaluated. The streets for the next go around. Right, because this one's sort of worried tonight. We sent all of you this list a couple months ago.
And the list that we have not included is that we're asking for you to approve. We actually still have 36 sections of street segments left on our current list.
Right, the only change in this list is that we removed Eber and Jerry Jones because it was done under change order last month to get a better price and save our taxpayer.
Jerry Jones and Eagles and more or less they put in 2014. That's right.
Excuse me?
Sorry, can you hear? Okay, Jerry Jones and Eagles was put on 2014. That's right.
Right.
This 2015, this will be
a good. It is actually coming out of the 2015 budget. We actually have, as we submitted that information up to DOT, those were originally included on it, but we went ahead and broke it out. Instead of being on one list, it's actually on two. So it gets kind of confusing, but it's previously approved the 2015 list with DOT.
But this is the 2015 budget year, so this list will be done as soon as the contract ends. So
still on this as being one command is known, they took it off the list.
Right, it was removed from the list because we approved it, added it to the contract last meeting so that it could be done under an existing contract. So the contract was going to close the same road and paved two streets that were connecting to it. So it was paved last week. So it's been done. It was removed from this list. And we got a really good price to do it as part of another contract.
That was the add-on that Randy.
I understand that, but I'm just saying if it was a street to be done, we got to count for it and say it was done, but it was done.
Right, but it's paid for out of the same element, so that's why we had to spend $571,000. So it's this bid of 341 and the 240 that was paid for by that street being done last week. So it's the same pool of money.
It's just not included in the list of the package for this one since it was approved last month.
Yeah, the element will pay for the Jerry Jones and it will pay for this one. So it'll pay for both.
And you said we had 36 streets still remaining on the list?
Yes, sir. From the streets that have been put in, and what happened is when we put together our list and we get how much money we're able to receive from SLOSS, from LMIG, then what we do is we take street gets put in that has like a higher priority, that like the basis building, that actually go on the list. So they don't go away, we keep that list, this money is available, and we work the streets off.
Can you just pull that list of 36 and send it to us?
Yes, sir.
Mayor, I think it'd be appropriate time to also say how much I appreciate the speed at which Speaker Jerry Jones, I've had a large number of folks call me, thanking the city and thanking Randy and his team and Sparks, I think, who did the researching itself extremely well, and obviously considering how bumpy Eager Road and Jerry Jones was on those base repairs, it's nice to see them out there. I think it was a great job.
Well, the good thing was they were already going to do Japan and Walmart, so they could simply add to this street too, and they were already crossing it and already closing traffic, all of that already had to be done, so, you know, they were already planning to do the work, we just got to take advantage of that opportunity.
Yeah, it was.
And Scruggs, of course, is a little bitter on this, and they, they'll do some of the good work.
Yeah.
You are right, but they've wasted the time to do it. They did it.
Yes, sir.
Who will be after J.C. Shack and Cleveland? We got Bosco, we got them in that area. Just five more of them rolling.
Right, it's actually a sandbag head wall, which you have in the drainage budget, kind of in replacement sandbag head walls, addition budget. We've got to get the road evaluated to see if there's base failure on it, if that is the case. As long as the pipe is good, then we'll need to come in and pull that section of the road out, and that would be done